We are with first team All Sun Belt, Cheyenne Hayes from Troy. Now, Cheyenne, you're listed as 5'9". You are 5'9" on a good day. I would say with a couple with like pairs of shoes and some cushion on that, but you fly. So how is it playing at the top level and receiving those type of honors?
It's definitely really exciting. I never thought that like I would be in the position that I am right now. Definitely props to my teammates. They helped me out a lot. I could not do it without them. And of course, the training that we put in every single day, whether that's in the workout room or practice, it's definitely helped me, but it's definitely exciting. I really enjoy like relaying the message of kind of my story, how I switched a bunch of different positions and, you know, kind of set 1 year because I was too short in club, and being able to kind of go back to the position that, you know, I really enjoy playing and definitely has my heart always outside hitter. But no, it's really exciting to be able to play at the level and be an undersized outside hitter.
And you're a six rotation player. You can defend. You pass so well. Great technique, by the way, on your pass. I like it a lot.
Thank you.
But out of club, you were committed to another school.
Yeah.
You were actually walking on to that other school. But when Josh took over the program at Troy, he saw your value. He always saw what you could do. And you could ball. You could pass. You can swing. It did not matter how tall the blockers were. You could work around the block. So how important was that to play for a coach and commit to a coach that sees your value?
It's very important because I feel for me, playing after college was never really something that I thought about. Maybe it is a little more because I'm not ready to be done now that it's my senior year. But the reason why I was so like pressed into, you know, Coach Josh and how he valued me was because I wanted to be able to play 4 years if it was going to be my last time, just because after those 4 years, so many different things are happening in your life. You know, you don't know if you want to continue volleyball for professional or, you know, maybe sand is out there. I don't know. Or if you want to go into your job, that kind of stuff. So I definitely realized that I wanted to go somewhere that I would, you know, definitely be able to play and definitely get that value. It's very important, especially not only my coaches, but with my teammates as well.
So this happens a lot to club players. They are looking at places that they could play, but you choosing a place where you looked and you saw the other outside hitters and you're like, you know what? I can start there my freshman year. I can go in and make a difference, and you're making that difference. Mm-hmm. So what would you say to those club players, those high school players that are weighing their options between a couple different schools to choose a location where they can go in and make a difference?
Yeah, for sure. One of the biggest things that I think I would tell club players is don't really settle. I think that I was kind of really over the recruiting process when I was kind of 16, 17. And I just jumped right into something. Definitely there's pros and cons to that. I think I learned a lot about myself committing that early, but at the same time, I kind of wish that I would have waited a little bit and definitely like looked at the team dynamic more, maybe the coaching situation. There's a lot more things that I wish I would have looked at before I would have committed so soon. But I'm definitely thankful for kind of the way that it played out. In the moment, I was very stressed and it definitely took a lot out of me. And one of the things that I would say is just take your time, like really focus in and weigh all the options. Look at everything. I mean, sometimes it may be the school that you want to go to. And sometimes it's just like the volleyball program is so strong and the culture is so great. And I say go for that. I mean, our culture at Troy is just amazing. All of my teammates are awesome. The coaches are awesome. Like, I'm just ready to have a normal season, hopefully.
I truly believe everyone has a destiny and you're living your destiny right now, Cheyenne. And let's talk about your mom a little bit. We're going to give your mom a little shout out. She was an Atlanta Falcon cheerleader and your sister just committed to cheer at Troy. So she's following in your footsteps for the school. So to all cheerleaders out there, Cheyenne, you're the person that has got to answer this. Is cheerleading a sport? Everybody's going to kill me for that. But I know the answer. Go, Cheyenne.
I definitely think it is. I mean, if you have not gone to a cheer competition, I suggest you go. Maybe not the whole day. It's kind of a little different than club volleyball tournaments, but it's intense what they do at those cheer competitions. I mean, I would not want to flip my body around, catch all those girls. It's pretty intense, but I'm really excited to have my sister on campus. It'll be interesting for sure. Maybe she'll get to cheer at some of my volleyball games.
And we're going to recruit her over to the volleyball gym and
yes.
Be like, hey, cheer number three. Yes. Go, Cheyenne. So yeah, glad we covered that. Now, Cheyenne, going into this season, hopefully have one. What are your expectations?
I think that last year, we set the bar really high. We trained super hard, and I don't think that we were kind of expecting for our season to kind of play out the way that it did last year. And I think that this year we are super optimistic as well, and we've set that bar even higher, and I think that that's super exciting. I think it is very nerve-wracking with all the uncertainty going on. If we're going to have a season, how many games are we going to play? Is it going to be just conference? But I think that no matter what, we're super prepared right now. We've been working super hard the past 2 weeks that we've been in Troy, and we're just ready to all 16 of us get on the court at the same time with our coaches. So just fingers crossed that that happens, and if not, you know, we'll kind of go from there and continue to train hard.
Well, hopefully we get a season, and hopefully we get to see you ball on the court working all your different shots. My favorite, Cheyenne, is your tool shot off the hands. It's like nobody does it better.
For sure.
Well, great job. We're cheering for you.
Oh, thank you.